without further ado, give it up for Chris.
Oh, it's really nice. So I have a series of videos. There are six of them in all. Three of them have been published and are up on the site. This is the fourth video that I'm working on right now. And it's kind of, it's not something I claim expertise in. It's a learning experience for me as I'm putting it together. So, as I was saying, there are kind of two types of augmented reality out there. It's either camera through, and that's when you've got a camera on the front of the lens, and you've got a video screen in front of the eye, and then there's view through, and that's where you've got a transparent lens, and there's some means of putting the display onto the lens, but it's transparent, you can still see through. And as I was saying, I'm focusing on view through. And it's that I am going to have one camera view example toward the end. And then you have monoscopic versus stereoscopic, where you've got one or both eyes, whether it's going to be in 2D or 3D. And as with many technologies, there's kind of a typical path to market to a lot of this, where it starts off in laboratory, funded by the military, ends up in industrial use before it ends up kind of trickling down to consumers. And these were some images I found that were actually from universities. See, do you recognize any of these?
These were actually from companies.
I kind of set this up as a sort of intro. I actually don't know the background on some of these images. Neil Stevenson called it going gargoyle. For those familiar with Stone. Typically financed by the military, they kind of get a hold of the technology first. This is light eye. They have a maximum resolution of 800-600. Mono or stereoscopic. As I said, with all of these, it's a transparent. This one's head mounted. And when you're dealing with the military, you unfortunately don't have to worry about aesthetics. This is microvision, and these first two are both American companies. This is 800-600. They were developed for helicopter for the U.S. military, for not for the pilots, but for the other members of the helicopter team or whatever. And yep, there you go, the gun. I presume the pilot would have a lot of this in their common view as well. Microvision is primarily known in the consumer space for Pico projectors. They make a lot of those really small camera projectors and are selling them as an original equipment manufacturer to put their projectors into other companies' cell phones. So it's really tiny projectors, and they also make commercial barcode scanners.
Are there any products that the Pico can actually in the market?
They have their own Pico projector. I don't know about the cell phones. As Noah and I are familiar with the Nomad model, great story here. They built these for Honda, and they were for the service centers at Honda dealerships, so that the mechanics could have all the manuals to all of their models available in this transparent heads-up display, and the mechanics didn't like them, and so they didn't use them, and they rolled them out for all the dealerships in North America, and so, and it was several years ago. and tried it out for a year, and the mechanics hated them, and they pulled the plug and discontinued them. So if you ever want to find one, you have to find Honda dealerships. That's where I bought mine from, was a Honda dealership in St. Louis. It had them sitting around in boxes because they weren't using them.
Can I ask a question? Was there something particular? Was there something particular they didn't like? They found them uncomfortable, or they
well,
didn't
I think
work.
This is my speculation. If you look at the, say, the personality type or the average auto mechanic, can you see the average auto mechanic working on your car wearing this thing? Or do you think they're just going to pull out their phone book size manual? That for what it's worth. So this is a kind of conceptual vision thing that Microvision put together, speculating the use of their eyewear in the consumer space. What were you going to say, Steve?
If you want some more speculation on that, because I haven't talked to lots of 100 folks, that design is a scaled-out version of what I actually bought from them. It's bigger and bulkier, but it also has a red scale display, and red scale is really unpleasant. You don't want to be bright, transparent background. As long as they're unpleasant. I found also a number of my students who swear later it's a laser-based display that they were seeing after images afterwards and they would never go again. Which I think is more suggestion than anything else, but I could imagine that.
I can see that. Like I said, I have one at home. I'm familiar with the display, I guess, but I've never worn it for hours. So like I said, this is their vision of how this might be implemented in a consumer product. Now, this is one I know very little about it. I found it in a press release from Olympus, and I don't know much more than the fact that they had these couple of images in a press release that they have this projector, as you can see, projecting sort of clamped onto the side of a regular pair of sunglasses, or a regular pair of eyeglasses. And the fellow was seeing, you know, information about this particular subway. The next one here, this is an Israeli company, Lumis Optics, and they did development for the Israeli military, and now they're looking for a partner in the consumer electronics space to try and take this market for the consumer. This video that they have is only showing an opaque video. Stereoscopic and transparent lenses, when you turn it off, they turn clear. But according to their documentation, it is also supposed to be able to display translucent. You're supposed to be able to look through them and see content as well, according to what they published about it. This next one is a pilot project by SAP. Company Texmo is pretty sure that they're French, is providing the hardware for the eyewear. SAP is developing the software and overseeing the program, and they're doing it at a Daimler Benz factory in the UK. And you see this fellow wearing it, and when he goes around, you can see, instead of having these paper printouts with all of the parts and everything that it needs for the assembly line, it's all there in this AR display. I really don't know anything about this company, Trivisio, except that it's a German company, and they advertise on their website that they do custom fabricated AR and VR eyewear, and they have a stereoscopic pair that they have up there. It was a custom fabricated piece up on their site. This is a French company, Laster, and I've actually had the opportunity to try out their leads. I went to Laval Virtual, was an event in Laval, France, just a couple of months ago, and they had a booth there, and it has a camera on it, and it does your head tracking, and it does computer vision to recognize. I presume you can recognize markers. But in the demo case, they had a picture of a globe, or not a picture. They actually had a physical globe, three dimensional, out in their booth, and you would sit down, and when you looked at this globe, it would display all the satellites, all the major sort of constellation of satellites orbiting all around the world, and then. You could use the navigation that you could see in your field of vision to select specific satellites and pull up information about them, and then there would be a 3D model of that particular satellite kind of floating out in front of you, and it would give you information about the satellite. It was a pretty impressive demo. One of the more impressive ones I've seen actually in space. Photo courtesy of Mr. Thomas over at Ishijor. Now, this is the only one I'm going to talk about that's actually camera to video as opposed to view through lens. And I bring it up because it's the only one that most people that have used a VR display have probably used. It's got to be the largest one out there in the market in terms of. I think together when you buy, it's a two-part thing, you buy the VR920 with the CAM AR attachment, and I think together it's about $500. Like Paul Anoda, Steve Student brought in a pair of them, he's had them here at our presentations before. So it's not stereoscopic, so it's not in 3D, it's opaque, it's low resolution, but given all of that, it's still pretty capable. This is a demo put together by CIO2, an Italian software company. And they put this boat in the middle of a living room from a marker, and the fellows moved it in a three-dimensional through this, actually technically two-dimensional, through this particular physics AR eyewear. Now, this was a pair that they previewed at CES last year. It just sort of never came about, so we'll do that. Then they came out with a new pair, a little bit less ambitious. The previous pair was like high resolution, transparent lens, stereoscopic, all of this. This one now, it's stereoscopic, it's not transparent, it's in low resolution, it's video through, but it's Vuzix is kind of the only one that's putting out something that's affordable by the consumer. This, however, is kind of, it's kind of where we're at in terms of the consumer space, meaning that there isn't anything that's out there that your average person is going to wear walking down the street. You know, like I was talking about before, when you're in the military space, fashion isn't an issue, but aesthetics matter when you're trying to market something to consumers. But that shouldn't be too discouraging, because there was a time before earbuds and iPods, and even before Walkman, that many of our technologies weren't, you know, as slick as they are today, and they do improve over time. These are two things that are in the lab. This is SVG Labs. They were at ARNY on the panel. They use a pretty ingenious system where they have a hologram of what are essentially a hologram of mirrors across the lens, that when you're looking at the lens, it looks like a clear lens, but these hologram of these mirrors are reflecting the video display and the field of view. And this last piece from the lab, this is a patent that Apple was awarded. And kind of from reading over the patent filing and using this illustration, I put together a little animation here that kind of shows how this works, where they're projecting into the edge between the nose piece. But if you know how, like a piece of fiber optic cable, when you're looking at it sideways, you don't see the light, you only see the light from the end. Well, this kind of works sort of the same way, where it has that double lens with two mirrors on the edge, and it's projecting the video display through the lens sideways, and then brings it out and displays it on the front lens in front of you. Just to kind of wrap up here, if you're not the glasses type, there's always Babak Parvez over at the University of Washington, who's working on his video display contact lenses. And if you have, this is a little ways off, but if you're willing to sort of forego your own eyes, MIT has a project pumping the video into your optical nerve, and if that's not straight to the source enough for you, there's always the option from Caltech. Where they put the brain implant in. Actually, this is for a prosthetic arm, and that's not even their arm. That's the University of Chicago's arm. That's all I've got.
Thanks a lot, Chris. If you have questions, send an email to Chris.